My name is Ocean Mukubane. I met David Collins in 2013. He was called and asked to come and assist in Soweto when I met him. I wasn't interested in the work, but I was prepared to assist in our communities. David Collins, under the UO Act, invited us to the Foundation Clinic for a training in recovery coaching. And I was just driving people there to go and learn. I thought, I don't need the tool. And when I got there, I got hooked. And today, since 2013, I'm a recovery coach. I'm a missionary worker. I'm a Christian missionary. I took it upon myself when the tool changed my life that I'd like to impart the knowledge that I had gotten. So we started working with David Collins because the Nyaupe drug had scared the country. The youth of the country was using a new drug called Nyaupe, and it was spreading like wildfire in our communities, in the whole country. And we were called to come and intervene. It was urgent. We went all over the country where we were called. There were some donations here and there that UACT would go out and get for us. But it was difficult. UACT had to carry most of the costs of going around the country. But it was gratifying also to go out and use the tool. As I was facilitating the tool, I thought I was just going in there to impart and go away. And the difference between this tool and all other facilitation workshops I had held under the ETDP CETA, this tool changed my life. It became a lifestyle. There was no way that I would look at addiction and think, I'm not an addict and therefore I'll just teach and go away. I started unlearning my own prejudices. I started unlearning my judgments. I realized that my expectations of others were impossible. So the tool and the processes of the tool and the resources within the tool changed my own life. And David Collins invited us to a pilgrimage. I mean, I'm the Christian here, the Christian missionary. I was invited to a pilgrimage. I went to that pilgrimage. And at that pilgrimage, I found myself. I started to learn what love is. I started to manage my own expectations of others. And we then went out to go train communities. I still enjoy face-to-face training with the communities. We went as far as Cape Town. We went as far as the Eastern Cape. We went to Limpopo. We covered almost the 9 provinces and even went to Botswana without financial backing from anyone. The only people who were assisting us was the UACT. And to date, I mean, during COVID, I remember we couldn't do any training and David came up with virtual meetings. Those were helpful for us and everyone who came to the virtual meetings. Unfortunately, we couldn't cover our communities who don't have the resources like your smartphone or a laptop or data. However, we were able to connect with other international recovery coaches. The tool has grown in the country. We've got referral centers that started where our communities can take their clients to the referral centers. And there's work that we've done. We've covered ground. I'm happy now that I've done some work. It's gratifying. It's gratifying to meet people who were in addiction and now are running referral centers. Some of them are working at rehabilitation centers. I'm blessed to have had this journey. I'm blessed to have impacted myself and other people by facilitating this tool. I'm still facilitating the tool in communities. The only resource I don't have is the financial resource. I'm hopeful that the other coaches who come, who take the baiting from us, they will find financial assistance. It wasn't very easy to do this work without financial assistance. As it is, we've made inroads into cricket. We're hopeful that we'll go into the arts. I have a dream that one day this tool will be taught at universities and at colleges, you know, so that people can be as blessed as I am and to be able to impart such a powerful tool to our communities. I manage my own expectations now. I look at the world with a different eye. I know what peace means. I know what love means. Thank you. Thank you, David Collins, and UACT. You were a blessing to me, and I believe that I'm a blessing to others. Let the tool grow and keep on growing. I hope our work will continue. Yes, till we've left this earth.